News that the great Buddy Holly had died in a plane crash affected me deeply, for no reason I could understand other than that I'd seen him when he toured Britain last year. The racing driver Mike Hawthorne died, but I'd never seen him, so I couldn't care less. Nor did I care about Henry Cooper becoming Empire champion after 15 rounds at Earl's Court. I might have been interested if I hadn't had to sit there with Jack and the Kray twins and my dad, Joey Oldman, all acting like they were pals. Underneath, I hoped Jack was as angry with them as me and was just biding his time. Jack was so volatile and you never could tell with him. Most of all, I was cross with Joey for fixing this all up without a dicky bird to me. He was still getting more houses in West London to rent to blacks, and there were still plenty of them coming over here. What upset me most and sent me crazy was losing Leah. She had vanished like she had never existed. I think my poisonous mother, Cath, had something to do with it. She denied it, of course. So did Jack and Leah's dad. She had left the hospital and simply disappeared. I didn't give up on her. I couldn't, because I couldn't get her out of my mind. Nor did I want to.
There you go, baby. Here am I. Oh, will you left me here so I could sit and cry?
We present G F Newman's The Corrupted, Episode 9.
Brian? Brian, is that you?
I think it is. Father Christmas.
Where are you going? You come in here and behave like a proper human being and say hello.
That looks good.
Why don't you wait for your tea? Not that you deserve any tea.
Probably not.
You got something to tell me?
Have you got, Mother? You and Joey must be millionaires with all this property. Should watch your H's.
To hear you talk, you'd think we was Lord and Lady Docker. What have you got to tell me?
The time, by my H-Samuel Everite watch, is 20 past six.
You're not too big to get my hand round your bloody face, my boy. Now what?
About what?
Like where you've been all afternoon.
Have been.
Your dad went to your shop to do the stock take and you'd gone.
What am I, a bloody skivvy? I can't take 10 minutes off.
You're the manager.
It's a poxy greengrocer's shop.
Hey!
Don't you come it with me. We work our fingers to the bone to provide a living for you.
Some living? I'll get less than the help.
Your family, it's all for your benefit.
Oh, yeah, like cool, mummy-o. That's why I'm shut out of everything. Joey's doing deals I only get to know about from Jack, if he happens to want to tell Muggins here.
No one's shutting you out. You were ill. We had to protect you.
So why aren't I being told now?
We thought you were running off with the tailor's daughter with her grand ways.
Well, I would if I knew who she was.
It's as well you don't, then. What good's she to you?
I love her.
What would you know about love? Anyway, I'm sure your dad knows.
How? How does he know?
I expect Sammy Cohen told him.
The old titzer! He told me he didn't know.
We're all trying to protect you.
Kill him. How long's Joey known? Where's he now?
He's gone to meet John Bloom about something at his factory.
See, there we go again. Someone I'm not supposed to know about.
She wasn't no good for you, Brian. You can do better than the daughter of that thieving tailor.
Oh, can I? Well, I would meet Leah. Yes, that's her name. I would meet her and I'd marry her tomorrow if I could. She's the only person that's ever made me feel anything about another human being.
Well, talk to your dad when he comes back. See what he's got to say.
Talk to him now. I might kill myself.
Silly. Well, what about your tea?
It's not tea. An evening meal is either dinner or supper.
Oh, it's a bit of a setup, John.
That bit of early finance from you made all the difference.
Yeah. Who's this coming?
Night watchman. It's only me, Ernie, Mr. Bloom. We'll lock up when we go.
How many washing machines can they turn out a week?
As many as we can sell. I've done a deal here for 25,000 units initially.
What? All on our purchase?
For a fiver deposit.
That still leaves 1,125,000 quid to finance. At what, 8-9%?
Nearer 15, over 2 years.
On our sum or reducing?
You ask more questions to my bank manager, Joey.
He asked enough to know he doesn't want this sort of risk.
He's a fool.
I can't raise that sort of geld. I could cover a bit more of it.
It's the early part that carries the risk. Then it becomes self-funding.
Yeah, the bank manager I know will want more information. How much have you allowed for bad debt and breakdown repairs in the guarantee period?
They're cut to the bone. It's the only way we can halve the price of the machines in the shops.
Yeah. What's the anticipated profit margin?
19%.
Provided breakdowns are at a minimum and not too many run out on you. Any credit checks?
What are they worth, Joey? If they've got the fiver deposit, they get a washing machine. These are for women who've had to do the family wash in the old copper. They're not going to let their husbands miss payments.
As yet, it's not as profitable as those houses of mine in Notting Hill. But how long can that go on with the Schwarzers? Like I said, I'll come in for a bit more and I'll talk to Keith Griffiths, the bank manager. You'll need to slip him a few quid, John.
He sounds like my sort of bank manager. Who's this? You're Brian.
Brian, what are you doing here?
Mum said you were here.
Well, you know John Bloom.
Yeah. We need to talk.
What about?
This sounds like a family matter. You let yourself out, Joey.
I'll give you a tinkle after I've talked to the bank. Come on, Brian.
Just what's going on with John Bloom? They're so hush-hush.
Whatever it is, Brian, never come into a business meeting with any kind of emotion.
Well, I wasn't a part of it.
Nor will you be unless you learn to control your feelings. Or at least, don't let them show. That's the secret of getting a good deal.
Mum said you know where Leah is.
Did she now?
She said Sammy Cohen told you.
Oh, why do you think he didn't tell you, Brian?
Because he doesn't want me to marry her. He thinks I'm a sissy. I love her, Dad. I want to marry her.
I've waited a long time to hear something like that from you, son. Haven't I just? She's down at Southampton.
What's she doing there? Nursing?
She's at university, studying psychology.
Bloody hell! Why didn't you tell me? I've been going crazy thinking something had happened to her.
Sammy Cohen was trying to protect her.
But I love her!
It's not you, Brian. It's Jack he wants to keep away from her.
Him? I'll kill him if he tries it on with her.
More emotion. Use your head. You're getting stronger all the while, but in a fight with Jack, you couldn't protect her. Not unless you did something you'd go to prison for, and who would that help?
If we were married, Jack couldn't do anything. He wouldn't dare.
Now you're using your head.
Do you think she would marry me, Dad?
From what Sammy told me, I think there's a good chance.
I can't believe it. That's smashing!
Yeah, she hasn't said yes yet, Brian. I'd help if you were solidly set up, not a greengrocery manager.
Well, then what chance have I got?
Keep emotion out of this. Then you'll be ready to come into business with me, as a full partner.
Doing what?
Managing those houses in Notting Hill. We've got over 300 tenants. Then there's this place.
What? This factory?
Yeah, we've got a bit of money invested in John Bloom. Gonna get a bit more. Just enough to try to influence him so he doesn't bite off more than he can chew. He's a bright man. Wants to make a lot of money fast. No fault there. We'll make some too. But what we have to do is use our head and see when the time is right to get out before his whole scheme collapses.
Won't we be able to stop that?
I don't think anyone will be able to stop Mr. Bloom doing just what he wants. Let's go home. Celebrate our new partnership with a nice cup of tea.
You sure you won't try anything a little stronger, Dad?
Drink just gives me more acidity. Brian, don't say anything to your mum about going off to see Leah until you've talked to her and I've talked to her dad.
Oh, right. I'd rather not tell mum until we're married.
Might be a bit tricky, son.
She might let slip to Jack where Leah is.
Good thinking. Now you're definitely using your head, partner.
I took my troubles down to Madame Ruth. You know that gypsy with the gold cap tooth. She's got a pad on 34th and Vine, selling little bottles of love potion number 9.
That's far too loud. You can hear it along the street.
That's the idea, Mum. You have to play it loud.
What are you getting so spruced up in aid of?
Oh, I have to go down the road on a bit of business.
What sort of business, Brian?
Just something Dad put me onto.
He didn't say anything to me. What's going on?
Ah, it's a surprise. Secret.
Well, you've changed, Brian. You never used to keep secrets from me.
I'm not keeping anything from you. It's just, I want to bring this to a conclusion and surprise you both.
Oh, I'm ever so pleased you've come to your senses about being in business proper with your dad. All that mooning around you did over that girl. You're much better off now. You'll make something of yourself, like that MP always said you would.
That's what I want to do, Mum. When I come back, I might have some real news for you.
You don't want one of us to come with you?
Give over, Mum. Nearly 21. I've got the vote, a driving licence. All I want now is the key to the door.
Well, you're not thinking of leaving home, are you? Well, I wouldn't think that's a sensible plan now you're getting started.
It's going to happen someday.
Well, who do your cooking and cleaning, do you think?
I expect you would, Mum. Or if I make enough money, I'll employ someone.
They never do it properly.
I've got to get going.
Well, do you want me to make you a sandwich before you go?
I don't need anything, Mum.
Your dad's seeing the bank manager. Perhaps you should have gone with him so you'll know all what's going on.
Nah, two's company in that sort of meeting. A third person's a potential witness against one of the others if anything goes wrong.
Nothing's going to go wrong.
I expect you're right.
You mind how you go in that new car of yours?
I will. It's not paid for yet.
You look gorgeous. I hope this mysterious man you're going to do business with is as chipper as you are.
I must say it all looks pretty sound to me, Mr. Oldman. The bank will underwrite 50% of the hire purchase agreements for a facility fee of £200 and 2% of the value of an accumulative rollover.
I thought you'd see its potential right away, Mr. Griffiths.
You have got the means to recover from defaulters or take back the washing machines.
I should say so. They're getting a lovely deal. No one gets them for free.
Well, the head office will want to know, Joey. I will have to pass it up there for approval.
Of course. Subject to their approval is your little bonus.
Paid in the usual way?
Cash in a plain envelope. Hmm.
This could be something my cousin would be interested in for his bank if you need extra finance.
John Bloom is always going to need extra finance the way he's expanding, Keith.
He could help you lose some of your cash much easier than I can, if that's of interest to you. He's always looking for new business.
Well, it depends what he'd charge and what assurances I'd get that my money is safe.
My cousin Julian is a most reliable and honest man, Joey. His is a private bank. He wouldn't pay interest on that sort of cash you put there.
As long as it's safe. That's better than paying 19 and 6 in the pound income tax.
I do wish you were a drinking man. We could toast our success.
Head office won't look too closely at the Bloom proposal.
With my recommendation, I'm sure they'll nod it through. I'll toast for you. Your good health.
Business was going well for Joey. All things he touched seemed to make him money. And I was pleased for him and pleased to be his partner. I felt like a bird as I drove my new Mini down to Southampton to find Leah Cohen. I was nervous as hell too, not being sure how she'd react. But I loved her so much, I believed that that was enough. Not knowing what the setup was at the university, I went to the college main gate and asked the porter if I could see her. I couldn't, but he directed me to try the student accommodation called the Small Halls.
I don't think the housekeeper's there. She's probably checking the rooms.
Oh, thanks. Hey, I'm looking for Leah Cohen. Do you know her?
Sorry.
Oh, do you mind if I go in and knock on a couple of doors?
Best not let the housekeeper catch you.
Thanks.
Leah? Hello? Leah? Oh, I'm looking for Leah Cohen. Do you know which room is hers?
What are you doing up here? Get out! Get out at once or I'll call the police.
It's all right, I'm looking for Leah. Leah Cohen?
It most certainly is not all right. Men are not allowed up here. Get out! Out, I said!
I want Leah!
Out!
Leah!
Get out!
Leah! Leah! Leah!
Brian, you'll get me thrown out of here. Is that what you want?
You went away. I've been trying for a month to find you.
I didn't want to be found. You must go back to London and leave me alone. I don't want to see you.
Don't say that, Leah. Please don't. I felt it was the end of the world when you disappeared. No one at the hospital knew.
That's how it had to be. I didn't want anyone following me.
Tell me what I've done wrong, Leah. please.
I don't think it would work between us, Brian. It just won't.
Please. I love you, Leah. I've never loved anyone before.
I thought I loved you, but then I'd have to take on your family as well. I can't.
You wouldn't. No, you wouldn't have to.
With your mum, I mean, that's weird. No. No, it's not. It's classic textbook stuff, a mother not being able to give up her only son.
But, Leah, I told her straight we had a big row. I'm now a full partner with Joey. It was him who told me where you were.
I suppose my dad told him. I'll have to leave here now.
Why?
It's your Uncle Jack. I had to get as far away from him as I could. He scares me. He's a psychopath. He frightens me so much.
What did he do? Did he tell you something about me? What?
He tried to make me go with him because of what happened in the past.
I'll kill him. I swear I'll kill him. Please, Leah. Give me a chance, please. I love you. I think... I mean, I do, but... Well, it's never happened to me before, so I don't know what I'm supposed to feel. It feels good, but I'm scared.
He said horrid, unkind things about you, what you were like. Is it true?
I could lie and make up things about my past. I don't want to. Not with you. Nothing I did or was matters. I've changed. I'm a different person for meeting you. I couldn't have changed if I didn't believe you had some feeling for me.
That uncle of yours was so angry, I had to run away.
God, I want to get him. He can't go back to London and kill him.
You mustn't. You're not like him, Brian. You're not. Just because someone in your family has that violence in them, it doesn't mean that you have. You're sensitive and kind and funny. I saw it at the hospital.
Oh, Leah, I do love you so much. Look, can we go and get some coffee somewhere?
Well, the coffee shops will all be closed. It's 10 to 6. There's a bench in the gardens. Bit chilly.
And the car's just along the street.
Just for 5 minutes. I have an essay I must write tonight. Brian and Minnie. All the students here are going crazy about them. How did you get it?
Joey, my dad, advanced me the deposit. It's on HP. Get in.
This is really cool, Brian.
Well, I can put the heater on if you're cold.
No, Brian, cool is good. Students use it all the time.
It's got a cool radio too.
Not so cool.
I want to show you something. Hey, give me a hand here. Can you feel it? My heart. It's like a trapped bird. Only you can set it free, Leah.
Oh, you are different, Brian. You're quite poetical. You should be here reading English.
I'm sorry I came to your digs like that.
Oh, it's all right.
I might get you into trouble.
I'll let you into a secret. Students sometimes sneak boyfriends into their room.
How? With that old battle axe?
Well, most of the wardens turn a blind eye. You ran into Killjoy Suggs. She's usually busy watching the Gogglebox in the evening. She'll be going off duty in about 5 minutes.
She will.
Brian, you won't ever let Jack Braden know I'm here.
Of course I won't. I never would, no matter what.
Shall we try and set that trapped bird free?
Cold room.
Come here.
Oh my God, Leah.
I've wanted to kiss you like that so many times. Almost from when I first saw you all broken in the hospital. I knew somehow we were meant to be together.
Did you? Did you really?
This was unbelievable to me. I thought I was dreaming. as I had many times since meeting Leah. Her saying the sort of things she did was almost too good to be true. The great surges of feeling I had then, I didn't ever want to stop. I didn't think they would ever stop. I believed I would go on loving her my entire life. As we went on kissing, my dirty great erection stood out like a tent pole. The more I arched my back to stop her feeling it, in case it scared her, the more she pressed into me. At first, I couldn't hear her words. I was too excited to register them. But then when I did, it was like balm.
It's all right, Brian. Yes, it is. I love you so much.
How with the woman you loved, did you get to the next part? I didn't know. She undid the buttons down the front of her dress as my hands were shaking too much. She stepped out of it and threw it onto the chair. Then I pulled a slip up over her head and she was standing in her pants and bra and her darn stockings held up with a suspender belt. I fumbled with my belt and stumbled over the narrow bed trying to get my trousers off, kissing the whole while. Between us, we got off her panties and my shorts. And then it happened. Like some dark and malevolent stain deep inside of me, waiting to remind me of what I was and drag me back there. Seeing her naked before me, my erection vanished. And with it all the feeling in my body, like water draining out of the bath. Finally, there was nothing left. Not a pulse or stirring of any kind. Short of crying, I didn't know what to do.
It's all right, Brian. It's all right, my darling. Don't worry. It'll come back. It will.
What happened? I can't believe my name.
Brian, darling, calm down. It's all right, my darling. It is. It's so easy for girls, but not for boys.
Why? Why?
Despite her words, I couldn't calm down. Panic assailed me. I could feel Leah's soft hands on me, and their touch was nice as she squeezed and stroked me, but the feeling reached nowhere beyond skin deep. A scream started in my mind and I fought it as anxiety rose in me. Oh God, why? Why now with this woman, the one woman I loved and who loved me in return? Tears spilled out of my eyes, making me feel even more inadequate.
Why? I just wanted to be so nice to you. The feeling as I do about you. I didn't want to disappoint you in any way.
You don't. You haven't. You can't disappoint me. Don't be silly.
Loving like a big girl.
Because you think you've disappointed me, and that's such a nice compliment.
Suddenly I knew what the problem was. Who she reminded me of. Who she was so like. But then it was too late. Her hands were on me. And I was getting good and hard and sliding into her as wave upon wave of fear boiled down on me, as I was drawn in further and further into a trap. There was no way I could escape. I screwed up my eyes tightly, trying to shut her out. The image behind my eyes was speaking to me, her words battering my brain, mocking me, telling me Leah was a dirty kike, a prostitute, not worthy of me. The image of my granddad flew up at me as the flesh peeled off the side of his head from the blows my mum struck him. She was saying how I'd get the same if I didn't do as she said.
No! No!
Quiet, Brian!
No!
Quiet, quiet!
No!
Hear us!
Quiet, Mum!
Quiet!
Quiet!
No!
Darren, no! 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 No!
This is outrageous. The police keeping him on remand. That girl probably got no more than she deserved.
Don't say that, Cath. Not until we get to see Brian and talk to him.
I know my own son. I know what that bloody girl was. Can't that DR Drury do anything now he's been promoted, Jack? I thought you paid him.
It's not the Met what nicked Brian, Cath. It's the Southampton police.
They can't be in any less need of money than London cops.
Drury's trying to find someone down there what we can put a few notes into. They are serious charges laid on Brian.
Silly boy, sneaking off behind my back. You encouraging him like that, Joey Oldman.
I wish you'd told me where she was, Joey. I'd have gone down there.
On the gain is where she belongs. Putting my son in jail like that.
I'll go and see my brief, Arnold Goodman. See what he can do.
Thank you, Janet. Mr. Oldman will appreciate your tea.
How wise you are, leaving the hard stuff alone. Was it a problem, Joey?
I never liked the taste. Alcohol always left a bad taste in my mouth.
This predicament your son's in is very serious. He could go to prison for a long while.
If he's found guilty.
Let's assume he will be, for the nonce. I told you I don't do these sort of cases, but I can find you the best criminal solicitor and the best barrister to be had.
All very expensive, I dare say.
The best usually are, Joey. No matter which way we slice it, there are going to be costs involved.
I'd never hear the last of it from his mother if I just let Brian do his time.
I think perhaps the most cost-effective way of mitigating that is get some of the charges reduced.
How can we do that?
The obvious way may be for him to plead guilty to a lesser charge. It's not without risk. Alternatively, you said you had a policeman who works for you?
Detective Chief Inspector Drury. He went to Southampton and offered the coppers there some money to drop the charges.
Send him back. This time, offer them money to drop the more serious charges, like rape and GBH, for common assault. That way, it could be dealt with by a magistrate. The most he would get is 6 months.
6 months. I don't know what his mother would say.
I think your wife has to be realistic, Joey. 6 months would be a good result. He'd only serve 4 months, less the time served on remand. He'd be out soon after Christmas.
I'll talk to Ken Drury.
On the positive side, your bid for those three houses in Notting Hill was accepted. You beat off Peter Rackman. He was offering too low. Cheap.
How much did they cost me?
A little under 10,000 for the three, plus 400 in cash to the property manager for tipping us the price.
That'll take some earning back in rents.
And put the rents up, or put more Schwarzers to a room. They won't care. You treat them well compared to the way Peter Rackman operates.
I heard he was getting out of rentals and developing property.
That might be good publicity for him. I wouldn't rely on it, Joey. First things first. See your policeman and get your son sorted out.
It's a bit of a rat's nest, Joey. What are you going to do with all this space?
Let it as fast as I can to as many West Indian immigrants as I can.
What about the sitting tenants? You want me to get them to leave?
In view of what you tell me about the special squad that's been set up to investigate Peter Rackman, I think we'll leave them be.
Very wise. I expect they'll leave soon enough. How much are you prepared to put into the Southampton police to get the heavy charges against Brian dropped?
As little as possible, Mr. Drury.
I can't see them police being any less greedy than those in the Met. I should think 2 ton apiece per charge.
1,200? They want my blood as well. Try them with £100 apiece per charge.
I'll give it a go, Joey. Nothing ventured. Oh, look. Them window frames are rotten.
Bit of putty, a coat of paint, it'll be fine. Do what you can in Southampton. You know I'll meet your price.
So that's the Queen Elizabeth, is it? It's a bit of a ship.
I thought you'd like to see it.
Huh?
Also, I don't like talking in the police station. You don't know who might be listening.
I can see you're a policeman after my own heart, Mr. Beaumont.
Oh, call me Derek, Ken. If two detectives can't trust one another, what hope is there?
What do you think about those charges against Brian Oldman?
Something can be done. Of course, the easiest thing might be to get the girl to drop the charges.
No one knows where she is.
Oh, we do. I expect for a few bob we could let that slip. What sort of man is this Joey Oldman? Will he be there with our notes?
A tight little Jew who's got plenty. I make it a sacred duty to relieve him of some dosh for the benefit of underpaid policemen.
There are three of us involved on the case, Ken. We'd want £100 apiece.
3 ton? I think you mistake your holidays on the Queen Elizabeth, Derek.
You did do the girl a lot of damage. A wicked little sod.
And what about for her address?
100 will do it. Let me sound out the DPP about having the charges dropped.
Either way, you'll earn a nice few bob, Derek.
This is the smallest office available, Cath. 680 square feet on a 7-year lease at 12 guineas a week.
Daylight robbery. We should own a few of these, Joey.
Yeah, well, it does include gas and electric.
And someone to clean, I hope.
Do you tell Jack where we'd be?
Do you really need an office, Joey? It'll eat up money.
It's Brian who's eating into the money. Lord alone knows what he's going to cost us.
Well, you should never have set him in that girl's direction. I knew she'd be trouble.
There's his car. Do I sell it and lose a packet? Or meet the HP payments?
He'll be back before you know it. But this office will be a millstone.
Well, I can't go on running a business from our sitting room, Cath. People expect you to have proper premises.
As long as you know what you're doing. Next, it will be a secretary.
I want someone.
Well, can we trust anyone but family?
Coming up in a while, Joey. Not before time. Smart offices, that's what you need. Why here? Why not in the West End?
It costs enough here without your encouraging more extravagance.
So what's the decision about Brian? You want me to go and talk to Leah Cohen?
It makes a lot of sense, Joey.
What? It's risky. If it backfired, Brian could find himself spending even longer in jail.
But Inspector Drury said those Southampton policemen want £150 each for each of the charges they drop out. That's £900.
You heard what the Director of Public Prosecutions told them. He'd prosecute even if Leah didn't want to.
I don't see how if she ain't a witness. It might be worth the risk me going down to stop her putting the bubble in.
For now, we'd better let Kent Drury pay those greedy policemen. You'll be a lot happier, Cath, with him doing a few months rather than risk a long prison sentence for rape and GBH.
Give me the address, Joey. Might pop down there and see her anyway. She owes me a favour.
Perhaps you should stay away from her, Jack. At least until this is all settled.
Oh, well. You better take these offices if you don't want Jack's help. You've obviously got money to burn.
Makes sense, Joey.
Yeah, I suppose.
Will you stop following me, Jack? Please stop.
What are you going to do, call the police? That's a laugh.
I don't know how you got my whereabouts. It's supposed to be a secret.
I'll protect you from Brian.
I don't want you to.
Of course you do. I'll take care of you, Leah. You're still very pretty. The scars will fade. It's all a memory of all this.
If you don't go away, I will scream and I will scream and the police will arrest you.
Or they could put you in the nut house. That might even do Brian some good, you making wild accusations.
Leave me alone! Please!
Jack's visit did the trick all right, only his thinking was a bit off. After his visit, the crazy woman ran away. She might have ended up in a nut house for all anyone knew. I was going to meet up with Leah much later in life, when I was serving 3 life sentences, but I'm getting ahead of myself. Leah was too scared to show up to court, but the police didn't let on to anyone that she was missing from her digs. Instead, they let me plead guilty to common assault. So with luck, I'd serve only about another 3 months, having spent a month on remand, and I'd get 2 months off for good behaviour. I was still angry with her, and just as angry with my mum. Right then I'd say I hated them both and didn't want to see either, nor Jack come to that. So they were about the last 2 visitors I wanted. Meanwhile, another corrupt policeman who was going to blight my life was just getting started on a life of crime. The orphan who Sergeant Watlin was keeping an eye on. It was ironical that Tony, as he was called, after Sergeant Watlin, and Wednesday, because that was the day he found him, should need a policeman to pull him out of trouble.
Cell number 2, did you say? Thanks, Pete. I'll straighten them out.
Hey, you crackers, son. Are you a mental retard? Didn't you listen to anything I taught you over the years, Tony? Get up before I kick the stuffing out of you.
Don't hit me again.
Or you what? Hit me back? Yeah, you're big enough to flatten me. Why don't you?
because you're a copper.
It's lucky for you, son, that the desk sergeant here knows me, or you'd have been down Shoreditch Magistrate Court in the morning. Then it wouldn't be back to the orphanage, but Ballstall. At least you didn't talk your head off or cry. I knew you wasn't a whiner. So, you like stealing?
It was the very first time.
Like, oh, you lying bugger. You're not stupid, anything but. A disappointment, though. I didn't come out to that orphanage every week with a bag of sweets to see you end up nicked.
No, you were shagging that fat sister in her office.
Ooh, you cunning little bleeder. Phew, look at you. You smile like Burt Lancaster in The Crimson Pirate. Teeth like a shark.
It's a good film.
Good smile will get you only so far, son. If you want to be a thief, get a licence.
More like a fishing licence.
Yeah, wouldn't that be handy? Popping along to the post office and paying over your shilling. No. The police are the only people with a licence to steal. Apart from the poxy government, what robs a working man every week. You join the police, Tony. You not only get a licence, other policemen protect you.
Well, how can I join the police? I ain't even old enough.
Someone as cunning as you was born old enough. It's the police cadets you'll be joining.
What about me getting nicked?
We take care of our own. Let's get you signed up and you'll have a job for life.
Can I really join?
You know what I like best about you, Tony? You know how to keep your mouth buttoned. That'll stand you in good stead in the police. Is why villains get caught. They can't keep quiet. Let's get you out of here.
In 1814, we took a little trip along with Colonel Jackson down the mighty Mississippi. We took a little bacon
enough,
and we
Sammy.
Took a little bean.
Would I go to New Orleans to live? I was 20 years younger. There, a man is free. The weather is free.
How do you get anyone to come in here to get measured for a suit, Sammy? Burton's is half the price.
So you come here to insult me? Montague Burton? All he could ever cut were army demob suits. I made your suits like you were born in them. Now, you insult me.
If you've got a nice bit of tonic mohair, you can make me a new whistle.
You want us to guess your size these days the way Montague Burton does? I'll put the tape over you.
Go on then, be a bit lively.
Bit lively? It's a disease nowadays. You can buy a suit off the peg. It fits where it touches.
How's your Leah getting on now, Sammy?
How should she be after what that animal did to her? If I was half my age, I'd go after him with an axe. Do I care? He's Joey's boy. He should be dead.
I always had a soft spot for your Leah, you know that. In fact, I wouldn't mind looking her up. See, she's all right.
So is she a film of the pictures that you can look her up? See what time she's
Sammy,
showing?
Sammy, calm down. It's me, Jack. I saved her from a fate worse than death, remember?
Should I forget? A father who had no power to stop his lovely matron being put into slavery by the Krays. I should go on living.
I want to make sure she's all right, Sammy. She's disappeared again.
It's only a few weeks since that monster violated my little Leah. Her body heals, but not her mind. How would she get that from her mind? She studies all the time, trying to understand what afflicts her. Maybe one day she finds a place in the academies and puts this behind her. Please, God.
In a few weeks' time, Brian gets out of clink. He'll be after her again.
Then I get an axe to him.
You, Sammy. No, I'll protect her. It'll be an honour.
The police can protect her.
Don't be daft. What'll they do? I protected you in the past.
So you charge my Leah for the privilege?
You know how I feel about her.
You'll be a reminder of the past, threatening to suck her back under, to lose her mind. She'd never forgive me.
It's either that or Brian, Sammy. What's the choice? One way or the other, we'll find her.
Oh. Why can't you and your family leave me alone? Please, go away.
I can't leave you alone, Leah. How could I? Look, I got you some flowers.
No, I don't want them.
I waited as long as I could. I wanted you to forget what happened with Brian. He behaved like an animal. Just give me a chance, Leah.
No, please. Go away.
You don't mean that. That doctor's done a terrific job. You still leave me breathless. You're so beautiful. You're shaking like a rabbit, Leah. I just want to take care of you. I love you, Leah. There, it's the truth.
No. No, you can't. You can't.
Look, I loved you from the off when you was with the Kray twins. You was just in need of someone to protect you. I'm going to do it, like I told your dad.
The only way you can do that now is by leaving me alone. I want you to go away and never come back. If you really loved me, you'd do as I ask.
I can't do that, Leah. You owe me, and it's time I collected. I'd say there was plenty of interest owing, too. I'll get us a nice gaff up in the West End. You can't stay in this rat's nest. It'll be good. I've got plenty of money. I'm going to take real good care of you. Come here.
Jack must have thought he was stepping into Errol Flynn's shoes now the movie star had died. He and Leah were welcome to each other. I'm sure they would make each other miserable. I felt nothing when Kath came and told me all about it. Life wasn't hard in prison. It seems I had a big reputation and the riffraff showed me a lot of respect. But it wasn't where I'd choose to be, especially not with so much going on that I was missing. They'd even opened the first motorway to Birmingham. Not that I wanted to go to Birmingham, but I would like to have driven my Mini along it at 90 miles an hour. It was in one of those motorways that Jack was destined to put the bodies of one or two people who crossed him. But I'm getting ahead of myself again.
Money don't get everything, it's true. But what it don't get, I can't use, I need money.
In G F Newman's The Corrupted, Joey Oldman was played by Toby Jones, Kath Oldman by Denise Goff, Brian Oldman by Joe Armstrong, Jack Braden, Tom Weston Jones, John Bloom, Theo Fraser Steele, the bank manager and D.I. Bulmer, Matthew Townsend, Arnold Goodman, Edward Max, D.I. Drury, Matthew Marsh, Sammy Cohen, Jonathan Taffler, Leah Cohen, Jasmine Hyde, Sergeant Watling, Nigel Cook, Tony Wednesday, Patrice Joseph, and the student, Kelly Shirley, with Ross Kemp as narrator. Other parts played by members of the cast. G.F. Newman's The Corrupted is a Pacificus production produced and directed by Clive Brill for BBC Radio 4.